Okay.
Hi, guys.
Hi, and welcome back to your next episode of The WedEd. We're laughing because me and Laura are physically and mentally drained and exhausted, which kind of explains why we've not put a podcast out for a couple of weeks.
Yeah, this is post-event hair.
We had an event
slicked
yesterday.
Back and sharp. Literally, we've been driving here to the podcast on the phone to each other, haven't we? Just...
Yeah, we just have a lot to tell
reflecting
you.
Reflecting on... everything that's been going on, it's been insane. It's been so busy. Listen, we've spoke about this before. This is peak season for us. It differs in different countries, but over here in the Middle East, this is peak season for weddings. And my God, has it been peak?
I know. I was going to say, I was trying to work out in the car since our last podcast how many weddings and corporate events we've done. And I think I counted 5 weddings and 9 corporates.
Already.
Right? Like, already. What?
And by the way, guys, when I'm talking peak season, I'm talking from like October to April. So all of that in basically a month. 2 months.
Get me some matchsticks.
Yeah, we've got coffee today.
We do. We've never brought coffee on set, but we're like, we need it today.
We needed it. We needed it. But yeah, we was kind of talking to each other and we're thinking, okay, what can we do as a topic for today? But there's been that much going on that we just want to have a bit of a catch up, a bit of a reflection, because there's been a kind of recurring motive that we've been experiencing over the past few events, haven't we?
Yeah. So basically we always take a really hands-on approach in couture events, and sometimes we'll have a client that will say, and we're actually very open, so we're happy to work with different vendors, different people, and we always say no problem, but just give us the details and then we'll speak to them beforehand and put them into the timeline, and generally it goes smoothly. But for some reason, recently we've had a couple of clients that have really, really wanted to bring in their own vendors at the last minute, and we've not really managed to fully vet them, and we've learned some valuable lessons which we thought we would share with you today.
Yeah.
It's like, where'd you start? There's been so many.
I guess it's one of them situations, before we go into it, of us trusting the client too much and the client not trusting us enough.
Yeah, that's actually really true.
Because, you know, when they're recommending someone, oh, you know, my family's used this person before, they've been in the industry, so, and you're like, okay, well, and you kind of check them out. We do vet them to an extent. You have a little look at the page.
Definitely.
Or whatever, and it's like, okay. And so in some instances, I mean, we always push to at least go with our vendors or try them, because it's relationships that these aren't friends. These are relationships that have been built over a period of time, loads of events, working on together.
We trust them.
We trust them. They know with one look of an eye, like, cut the music or do this.
True.
We don't need to talk. It just makes
our life so much easier working with the vendors that we've worked with. However, we would never force a couple to choose the vendors that we work with. We are open.
Exactly.
But we have been stung over the last couple of weeks. So we're going to share. So I wouldn't even know where to start. But I think my favorite one has to be the DJs.
Which, all the DJs lately.
So we've recently done a wedding. And the family brought us in very, very last minute. It was a very, very quick turnaround.
Yeah.
And they'd confirmed a lot of their vendors already, which is absolutely fine. And from our perspective, really all we can do at that stage is, you know, create the timeline, which was literally, like we've talked about before, minute by minute by minute. And then we contact all of the vendors and we say, right, this is your responsibility. This is what you need to have. You need to download this song, this song, this song for entrance, cake cutting, first dance. Like, we're very, very hands-on before they've even come to the venue. This is like several days before. But in this case, there was 2 DJs that were brought in. One was for outdoor and one was for indoor. So we're like, okay, fine, perfect. So we prep the DJ outside. The DJ outside is just responsible for the entrance song of the bride through an LED screen. And she's responsible for the cake cutting song. The DJ inside is responsible for the bride and groom walking in together, going into their first dance. That is it.
Yeah.
Other than playing music to get people up and dance and doing their usual job, which obviously is still a big responsibility. But these 3 moments are really important to our timeline.
Of course.
And to make sure that,
it's,
you know,
detrimental.
Yeah. And just to make sure that it's like me and Laura, we're, or Laura and I, we you know, couture events, it's all about the user experience, the guest experience.
Yeah.
And we want to make sure that it's like,
it's on point.
It's on point.
Yeah.
This didn't quite work out.
To be honest, it could have been a multitude of things. It could have been from their part. It could have been miscommunication because I know songs were changed last minute. It's a multitude of things, but it all goes down to, again, not working with the same vendors. Like, mm-hmm. we know no matter what changes are last minute, it's boom. If we say play a song, it's played. If mm-hmm. we on this moment, when we look at you like this, it means this. And there were certain instances where, you know, these big moments were approaching and we're giving looks and we're doing signals and they're just not getting it, even though we've briefed and it's just...
They've been briefed maybe 5 times by this point.
Yeah, and it's just... And also, to be fair, from their point as well, it is super stressful as well. And if they haven't Definitely. Worked with us as well, mm-hmm. it can also be confusing on their part. And in that, that's their peak moment. So when everyone's on them being like, play it, and you've got all these buttons to press and it's just... And also, they don't just want to plug it. They want to make sure it fades and it sounds good. And it's... But the one instance, we've got an entrance, like, into the ballroom...
No, that was the second one. Like, the first one was the entrance of the bride coming through the LED screen. So I'm behind the LED screen with the bride. She's very, very nervous. And any bride that's walking in and doing that type of entrance where everybody's staring them through an LED screen with... Was there smoke? Because I was the other side, so I didn't even see if there was smoke. But I think there was sparks. But I didn't see any of that because I'm at the back of the LED screen. So I'm waiting for the song. And they had a very specific song that was... it was a 20-minute song. So they'd said, we want it to start at 11 minutes, 50 seconds. Very specific, which we've briefed, which is in our timeline, which is written down, which is highlighted, which is given to the DJ, which has been explained to the DJ at least on the day 3 times, correct or not?
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm standing behind the LED screen and I'm like, the music starts and the bride looks at me and she goes, it's not the right song. And I'm like, what do you mean it's not the right song? So then I can see Laura and Laura's going, I can see her going to the DJ, it's not the right song. It's not the right song. And this has been practiced. And then, so, you know, from a planner's perspective, we're kind of like, at this point, you're at that firefighting part and you're like, right, do we just make a call and make the bride enter? And the bride was like, I'm not entering until my song comes on. So everybody's waiting. Everyone's waiting for the bride to come out. The bride's been announced. She's like, I'm not going out because the song, and the DJ couldn't find the song. She couldn't find the song in the right part.
Yeah.
And if that had been a DJ that we've worked with for years and years and years, that song would have been downloaded, been put at 11 minutes, 50 seconds.
Yeah.
And it would have just been done like that. And it's such a shame that that instance didn't happen. So that's one DJ.
May I note as well, at that point, they turned up an hour late for sound check as well, which could have also helped.
Yeah, 100%. Yeah, yeah, that. Yeah.
But then
the next DJ.
To be fair, I felt quite confident. Like, we've been briefed. Yeah, fine. Then the bride and groom did another entrance, a second entrance into the ballroom where they was going to go into their first dance. Very specific. This is the song.
The song was, they wanted to dance at 30 seconds. But what I explained to them was, by the time you walk, because they'd done a dance rehearsal, yeah, to be clear. So I'm like, by the time you walk and you do your entrance, by the time you reach the dance floor, it will be 30 seconds. So actually, let's just play the whole song. We don't just start it randomly.
Yeah.
And they were like, okay, fine. They were fine with that. Laura went and told the DJ was ready. And they start walking in. Completely different song.
No, it was the song that was supposed to be played before for the LED screen.
Not.
Yeah. So we're like, and this is like an upbeat song. And the other, this is it's supposed to be the first dance, like slow.
Like slow.
Yeah.
So all I see is Laura running to the DJ. I start running to the DJ and we're both like, what are you doing?
No, it's one of them. You know, when you're like, you're telling your child off and you're in public and you're like, play the song. Like through my teeth was crumbling. I was like, the song.
I genuinely don't think that mine looked as polite as that, because at this point I was like, what, like, just, and he's like, this is the song. I'm like, this is not the song.
Yeah But he was defending it. I'm like, no, this is not, it's like, if we're telling you, I'm not just up here for fun telling you it's not the one, play the song, just play it.
Play the song. So,
oh my god,
basically what we're trying to say is, arguably, you could be watching this and being like, yeah, but maybe it was just bad luck. This was one wedding, 2 DJs that we'd never work with that had been prepped in the right way, and they had been prepped, and I mean it, like, really. They'd been told multiple times, they had a written itinerary in front of them,
yeah,
and they still both got it wrong. And yeah, you know, that they were two very big moments. Luckily the client, we've worked with the client before, and you know, they were actually very sweet about it, and they knew that it was their error because they'd brought the DJs on themselves, right? But
yeah,
but we still feel a level of responsibility, and mm-hmm, we left and we're like, why do we keep doing this?
Yeah, but on that note as well, like, I don't want to sit here and slate the DJs because they're all very professional in their own craft. But in these cases, when it's not your vendor as such from a wedding planner, there's a lot of communication that comes from other parties as well. So from the family and everything that are speaking to the DJs. And so you don't know what's being communicated. Like, when it's under us, mm-hmm, everything that's been communicated is under us. We know exactly what they've been told. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So sometimes someone might be telling them one thing and then we might be coming and saying another thing and they get confused, which is why you might be thinking, oh, this is the song. Mm-hmm. So we don't know what he's been told before. So yeah, if it is all under you, you've got it all under control. Whereas sometimes if it's outsourced by the family or brought in as a friend or whatever, then it's a bit risque.
Definitely. But now we're going to move on to another instance that we've had where we have one very clear message for anyone watching, any planner, any bride that's watching. A vendor is somebody, I'm going to give you a definition of a vendor. A vendor is somebody that you pay a certain amount of money for to come to the wedding to do a job. Mm-hmm. This does not include your friends or people doing you favors.
Yeah.
Or someone saying, I'll do it for cheap. Or, oh, I know someone, somebody's sister's, auntie's, mother's, you know, brother's, cousin's dog. Like, no. Like, this has to be a person, a professional person that, yeah, has been given an X amount of money so that they're coming to do a job.
And that said person should not be part of the guest list.
100%. Now, the reason why we're telling you this story is because Laura and I had a wedding recently. Everything was going perfectly well. I have to set the scene because
we was way too chilled.
Like, we were so chilled. So chilled. Like, literally, even my partner came in and like, to be fair, like, your husband and my partner.
Avocado and toast.
Yeah, like, he literally came in and he's like, it's all done. This is the calmest I've ever seen you before a wedding. And he definitely jinxed it. Thanks, James. So literally, like, you know, we're fine. Laura's down in the ceremony area. All the guests are arriving. Everything's done. Like, no dramas, nothing. Like, super chilled. Laura's looking after the ceremony part. So she's, like, it was quite a walk, wasn't it? And I was, yeah, up with the guests. And I'm about to say to the guests, oh, you know, can you make your way down to the ceremony? This is, what, 4:45? Was it 4:45 at this point? Or 10
around
to 5?
About, yeah, yeah, yeah. Ceremony was starting at 5.
Starts at 5. And anyway, I see the groom for the first time. I'm like, oh, hey, how's it going? And he's like, Hannah, problem. And I'm like, oh, no, what? Like, it's been so smooth. And he's like, my mum hasn't had, like, the hair and makeup artist hasn't arrived for my mum. And I'm like, we have a very clear timeline. At not any point have we been prepped that there is a makeup artist, yeah, and a hair artist coming
hair and makeup?
Who are you talking
about? We've been told that the bride is having hers done separately. She came already.
Yeah, yeah. She's
Everyone
done.
Else was just coming ready.
Yeah. So I'm like, what do you mean? And he's like, well, they haven't turned up. And I'm like, well, who is the hair and makeup artist? I don't have a number, because if we have hair and makeup artists or whatever,
they're always
anybody,
on the list. Yeah. All the vendors. Other
we have the telephone list. Number, we make sure, mm-hmm, they've arrived on time, so there's no, so at least if they're half an hour late or like, okay, we can
updated.
Yeah, we can start planning something else. Mm-hmm. No, this is 10 minutes before ceremony. This is the mother of the groom. She has no hair. Her hair, she's come out the shower. Her hair is like a scarecrow. Bless her.
No, and she has no makeup. I'm there like mingling with the guests, whatever. And I just get like my pinky dragged into the, Hannah's like, get in the room now. Get in the room. So I'm like, I walk in, mother of the groom is just frantic, isn't she? Poor thing. Damp,
I mean, bless
hair.
Her.
Yeah.
Damp hair, like nothing's done. She's in, yeah, a beautiful dress.
Yeah.
With no hair and makeup.
No hair and
so
makeup.
I'm trying to call now. I've been given a number finally, and I'm like calling. And it was a friend of the bride, which, to be fair, she was doing a favor, and like, we're all for that. Like,
yeah,
you know, but the reason why you have a vendor that you pay a certain amount of money is because it's their responsibility, and mm-hmm, they're a professional. They're there to do a job. They're not there, yeah, to do anybody favors. She's in the car. I'm like, well, how long are you going to be? We're on the way. I'm like, okay.
How long?
The ceremony starts in 10 minutes. Like,
yeah,
you know, this is going to take a time. we're on the way, we got lost. And I'm like, anyway, in the end, it gets to 5 o'clock. And the main issue for us is that we didn't have any lighting in the ceremony area.
Yeah, because the client didn't want to get lighting down there just because they felt like they was only going to be there for a short amount of time. Mm-hmm. The rest of the wedding was going to be upstairs. So they wanted to put all of their budget there, which is fair enough. Yep. But obviously that meant that we was on a very, very strict timeline because sunset's at 5:30.
Yeah, it was 5:36 was sunset scheduled. So we were literally like
pitch black.
And then if you're not in Dubai, when the sun goes down, it goes black within 40 minutes. Yeah. Like it's black.
Yeah.
So I'm literally like, right, we really, really need to get a shift on. So I'm literally like, Laura, have you got your makeup back? So Laura's on makeup.
I'm like Sephora on wheels. I'm going. Like the foundation's 10 times too dark for her. I'm like, dab, dab, dab. I'm like, how do you want your eyeshadow? I'm trying to listen to what these makeup artists say.
She looked beautiful at the end. You did such a good job. I'm there. So then there was two flower girls. They didn't have their hair done either. And like, I don't have anything other than... I did have tongs.
We were shouting, like, anybody got any grips?
Yeah, there was no one had any grips. There was no grips anywhere. So we literally, like, were wedding planners / hair and makeup artists that day.
It was hilarious. And the thing that made me laugh as well, I was like, right, so what are we going to do with your hair? Like, I'll do your makeup first. What are we going to do with your hair? Let's just start getting it planned. She's like, well, I was thinking, like, two braids going up and up to. And I was like... I've just brushed mine.
Do you know what? It was just such an unnecessary, stressful part to the day. Because if we had known, and apparently she'd arrived in the hotel like at 3 p.m. She'd been told to get there at 3. Like we were already there at 3. If we had known.
If we'd have known, we could have just sorted something out.
You know, like we could have had some sort of plan B in place.
Yeah.
So the purpose of this story is, you know, it's always nice with your friends doing you a favor, but do yourself a favor. And just get a professional.
Yeah, because otherwise, like, there's no loyalty. Well, there's a loyalty there when you're paying, but there's no loyalty there when it's a favour or whatever. People just turn up, especially when these people are part of the guest list as well. They want to make sure, it's always number one. Like, they're going to make sure they look good as well.
Yeah, 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 definitely.
So, you know, and if they're running late or whatever, it's just...
Definitely.
So it's really one of them jack of all trades. And it goes back to one of the previous episodes, which about just expecting the unexpected. Like you've just got to be there.
We've had to do that so much over the last couple of weeks. We had
my beauty blender has been around.
We recently had a wedding as well. Again, it was a musician that was booked by the bride. And this was for a beautiful entrance for the bride to walk down the aisle. Now, this particular couple, the groom did an entrance to his song and then the bride was doing an entrance to her song. So this took a lot of us like working together because one of us is with the groom, one of us is with the bride, and then we've got someone else that's with music. So there was like, and we had to make sure that it was really flowing. So the groom enters for his song. And by the way, this was a really hot day, wasn't it? It was super hot. And the groom enters. And then this musician just starts playing another song. So literally, like Laura's like, I'm like, Laura, what's happening? And she's like, I don't know. And I'm like, can you try and persuade her to just play the right song? Literally, by the time the bride walked down the aisle, she was sweating, the groom was sweating, because it was so hot that day, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And what I was just like, I said to her afterwards, I was like, I just thought it would be nice. Like, stick to the timeline.
What are you doing? Like,
oh my goodness me. I mean, honestly, we've had a few, haven't we?
The icing on the cake, though, for me, was the photographers. This was this season as well. I just can't even, right? Going back to the thing about photographers being outsourced. We have a collection of photographers that we work very, very closely with.
Yep.
We know their quality of work and the relationship and everything. Again, same with the DJs. We know with one look or we know how they're going to approach it. And all of the photographers that we work with are very discreet. Mm-hmm. We wouldn't suggest someone otherwise because that's so important. Like a photographer is there to not be seen basically. And other than when they take you off for the photo shoot, they shouldn't be seen.
Yeah.
Capture the real life moments. But this particular one was specifically brought in from the client. I think there was to do with the family, maybe. I don't know.
Well, actually, we should have had alarm bells, because as they arrived in the venue, they start shouting at security because they didn't want to go and get their IDs. Yeah. And I was like, what's the problem?
And they were like, we just want to come in.
You know, they're based here. They understand they in Dubai, know. There's rules.
You in have every to give, hotel, you yeah. can't have access unless you have an ID. Like, if you're in the industry, that's a given. Your ID is on your forehead wherever you go. Like, you just... But yeah, they were shouting, which wasn't a great start, to be honest. Mm-hmm. But yeah, so we're cut down. We're in the ceremony and everyone's there upstanding for the bride. Bride starts walking down. Photographers are in place. We're like, yeah, boom, okay, ready. Bride starts commencing down the aisle. Little photographer runs in the aisle. Stop!
The photographer literally stopped.
Stop!
Bearing in mind... It's a song that's about a minute and 30 seconds to get the bride. And it was quite a long walk, wasn't it? From where she started to come down the aisle. Yeah. And she also had like about what, 5 bridesmaids, 2
flower
ushers,
girls,
flower girls. Like, it was a lot. It was a
party.
Procession.
Yeah.
And he's stopping all of them, like stopping them for photos. Stop. Click, click, click. And
he's in the aisle. He is in the aisle. Like, it was just this.
And at this point, you can't do what Laura mentioned earlier, where you're like, can you move on? You can't do that because they're literally in front of all the guests.
Yeah.
Like, he's literally in front of all the guests.
Like, the groom can't see her. Like, he's in the way. Like, the groom is starting to get teared up and then he's just swerved in. Like, and then he's there. And then the videographer comes along as well. So there's the two of them and they're like walking backwards as she's walking through the aisle. And I'm like, my lip is twitching. I'm like trying to smile, but I'm like.
And then the song ends, and she's not reached the end of the aisle. And then they proceed to stop her for more photos. So she's just stood there.
Silence.
And there's nothing we can do as planners. There is nothing we can do.
I was trying to like give an eye to the musician to be like, just keep playing. I was like, just didn't get it because he's so far away. And I was like, just.
But the drama actually doesn't end there. So then obviously we go in, the ceremony sort of continues and everything's fine.
It was beautiful.
Yeah. It was amazing. They go into a cocktail reception. At that point, Laura and I go into the ballroom where they're having their dinner to switch on all the candles.
Yeah. And thank God
we did. Bearing in mind, this is a white wedding. White tables, white flowers, everything's white. Everything's white. And we walk in and we went,
what is that?
And there is literally, I mean, I don't want to put this in a really vulgar way, but it just looked...
I'm going to say it. It looked like a prostitute card. Business cards. Like, you know these massage and the number? Black and red.
Black and red.
Business cards. On top of our beautiful decor.
Every
on top of
single,
the charger plate.
Every single charger plate had one. Every
black
single
and red.
And it was just, it was so red and it was so white. And all you could look at when you walked in that room was just all the red cards. And like, if you're not based in Dubai, there's certain parts of Dubai where like, you know, you can get like, they cover your car in these massage cards. And their business card looked like that. And I'm going, Laura, I swear to God, right? Laura put all the candles on. I had a wedge like this by the time I'd removed them. Like, you absolutely... cannot put a business card on a charger plate. I'm sorry. It's not okay.
It's not a time to promote. Like, have we put... Couture Events business cards are white. Like, we could have done...
They would have been so pretty.
They would have gone with the decor. But this is not the time to promote. You promote with your service, like how you are, how you're acting with the guests. That's enough. And then if people are interested, they'll come and brilliant, have your business card on you and give them. But on the decor, like... No, no. Like, next time I'm just going to put one of my passport photos on all of them. Like, I did this.
No, we wish that the drama ended there.
Oh, I wish it did. Honestly, I wish it did. So everything from that point was kind of fine. They was doing their thing. Yeah. Like, yeah, absolutely fine. And then we got all the guests in, didn't we?
Yeah, everyone
was
seated.
Yeah, and then we was going to do the bride and groom re-entrance into the reception area. And then, so Hannah's there with the bride and groom. She's like, right, go speak with a photographer and I'll sort that, get them ready, because it's a 30-second entrance. Like, there's 30 seconds left on the song from the DJ.
Look, if I hear back all of these stories, it's all about timings. Like, 11:50,
but that's,
1:30.
Yeah. It's stressful, yeah.
Yeah.
So there's 30 seconds left of that song. The DJ was going to fade it out. Then their entrance song was coming in. So I've gone over to the photographers. They're taking photos of a table it was literally just, I think there was work friends or something. They were just having fun. And I said, guys, really sorry to interrupt you. I'm going to need to take them away. Yeah, yeah, fine. Photographers, oh no, just one minute. I said, no, bride and groom are entering now. There's probably like 25 seconds at this point left. No, just 1 minute. Just completely disregarding me. I said, no, I'm getting stern now. I'm like, guys, I need you on the dance floor, ready. Bride and groom are entering now. You need to capture this moment. I'm the photographer and I'm in control. Make the blood. And I'm the wedding planner, so get on the dance floor.
She didn't quite say it like that.
The blood, honestly. Yeah. I was like, come on. No, I was like, seriously, guys, no, you need to, like, you need to get on the dance floor. You're here for the bride and groom. I need you to capture this.
Yeah.
Fine. Like, I wish I could say what was in my head.
I know. But yeah. I know. It has been, you know, and these are just, and honestly, these are four stories really of just something, but there's been so many more. It's kind of like, we've even had meetings where.
It doesn't even stop there. Oh, you're forgetting the part where bride and groom are doing the first dance and who's yamming a lamb chop at the side. He ran onto the dance floor with his camera, like, wiping his mouth. I'm like, oh, my God.
That business card
got ripped up.
Yeah, no, like I was saying, Laura and I have really sort of sat down and thought, how can we, you know, we've been in the industry for so long, how can we even prevent these moments? Because honestly, it has been consistent, hasn't it, in the last sort of couple of weeks where we've had a lot of this. Yeah. And, you know, we're so hands-on, even if we don't book those vendors ourselves. And we're trying to think, like, how do we manage it to make sure that these things don't happen? And I think that, you know, there's only so much you can do, isn't there? You know, what else can we do? Like, we do so much. We don't want to sort of be down their necks either.
There needs to be obviously a lesson. That's why we brought it up on the podcast, because there needs to be a lesson from it. And even we're learning as we're going along as well, which is why we want to obviously involve you guys so you're not making the same mistakes when you're starting out or you're carrying on your journey. But I think one of the important things is to, especially even from a client's perspective, like, to understand that wedding planning is a real job and it's a real service. Like, you wouldn't, a Michelin chef wouldn't let you bring a packed lunch to his restaurant. Do you know what I mean?
I hope not.
So yeah, like, there needs to be a certain level of trust, and you need to be able to put your foot down as a wedding planner and do push for your recommendations. This isn't based on commissions. This isn't based on anything. It's expertise, it's knowledge, it's relationships that have been built. So the client does need to kind of trust you in that respect. And of course, like we've said, there's only so much you can control, and it's their special day. So it's not our place to say who you can and can't. We can only recommend. Mm-hmm. But if they are adamant that they want to use a certain person or a certain vendor, I think it's important actually to have a line in your contract to be like, we'd like to you to use our vendors unless agreed otherwise. And if it is agreed otherwise, we need to meet them so many days in advance. Mm-hmm. We need to have X amount of rehearsals or practice or meetings or whatever, just because you don't need to do that if it's your own vendors because you're used to working together. But if it's someone unfamiliar, like, it's so important. Like, in these scenarios, people were being flown in or we was only meeting them on the day of the wedding, and it's just not good enough.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, I agree. So we've learned some lessons, and we really hope that you guys sort of can learn from us. That's the whole point of the WedEd, is really for us to sort of, I mean, obviously it's entertaining and, you know, but there is a really important message underneath it. And this is someone's special day. And ultimately, you know, we're there to make sure that they have the best day that they could possibly have. And unfortunately, there has been a handful of things with one consistent problem, which is vendors that aren't ours. So, you know, if you can try as much as you can to build those relationships with your vendors and, you know, really encourage your bride and groom to trust you throughout the process, that's what we would recommend.
Yeah.
That's certainly what we're going to really, you know, focus on for the next couple of weeks going forward.
I think as well, I actually seen something online which I thought was quite important. Just because you've planned a wedding, it doesn't make you a wedding planner. Mm-hmm. So if you've planned a wedding in a family or you've done something before, you don't see the back end that we do. You don't have the experience and the knowledge that we do. And in all of these instances that have happened, we've had the client come up to us afterwards and be like, oh, I wish we would have went with yours. Yep. And they know it. And they, yep. they've even apologized to us. And to be honest, I will say though, everything that we've mentioned, the client didn't realize it was going on. Mm-hmm, like they don't
apart
know,
from the entrance song.
Other than the entrance song. Yeah. But like, obviously it's our job to kind of just make sure that it's very discreet and we yep. take care of things behind the scenes. So it's more from our side where the stress is. But yeah, I think if you're a client or a potential bride or potential groom watching this and you are planning your wedding, it's also important for you to realize to also put some trust in your wedding planner. Mm-hmm. Like as much as we're there to make it look pretty and coordinate on the day, like you're hiring a professional.
Yeah.
If you're hiring a professional, just let them do the job and trust them.
Yep.
Trust their instinct.
Definitely. Well, we hope you found that helpful today. We do apologize for it being so long from our last one. We promise that we will not do that again, hopefully. But you never know. We're
but
so busy.
But you know what? Like we remain transparent on here. Yep. And it is a really, really busy season. And we don't want to put something out there which is bad content. Like we mm-hmm. want you guys to learn valuable lessons. And we are growing the WedEd community. So we just want it to all be the best that we can deliver, basically. So mm-hmm. So yeah, we do apologize. We've had actually some WedEd fans asking when the next one is dropping. Aww. So you're welcome. but yeah, we're looking forward to putting some more content. We've got loads of more things to tell you. Just haven't got the time to fit it all in yeah. this episode.
But, and we have some really, really great guests coming as well
in the coming
Yeah, coming pods.
Absolutely.
So stay tuned.
And once again, guys, we do have something really, really exciting that is coming in 2024, which is what all of this is for leading up to that moment. We can't wait to finally tell you what our plans are. The reason we have been a little bit quiet is because we have been putting things in place as well for that. So yeah, super, super excited where things are going.
So excited.
Got lots of things coming with couture events as well. Lots more happening in the rest of the season. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I'm sure there's going to be lots more lessons learned and lots more stories to fill you in on as we go along. But yeah, thank you as always for your support. Even though we have been quiet, the support hasn't stopped. So yeah, we really, really appreciate it. Thanks for watching this one. Mm-hmm. And
don't forget to like and subscribe.
Thanks so much, guys. And we will see you hopefully very soon.
Bye.